Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemy. This is Naveen and I'm part of the instructor team at MakerDemy. In this episode, we will learn about Wi-Fi 6 and its features. Wi-Fi 6 is the next generation of Wi-Fi. You might now be wondering what happened to the versions before Wi-Fi 6? See, the thing is that Wi-Fi has always had a bit of branding problem. As the standard is set by the IEEE, it uses the engineer's arcane numbering system. The original Wi-Fi standard was numbered 802.11. From Wi-Fi 6 onward, the Wi-Fi Alliance has rebranded the names to make it easier for the consumers. Most of us are either using 802.11n or 802.11ac Wi-Fi, which are Wi-Fi 4 and Wi-Fi 5 versions respectively. Now 802.11ax is rebranded to Wi-Fi 6. Wi-Fi 6 will still do the same basic functionality of connecting you to the internet, just with a bunch of additional technologies to make that happen more efficiently, speeding up the connection in the process. So how fast is it? The short answer is that it can transfer data at 9.6 gigabits per second. That is up from 6.9 gigabits per second on Wi-Fi 5. The real answer is that both of these speeds are theoretical maximums and are unlikely to reach in real-world Wi-Fi use. Nevertheless, Wi-Fi 6 achieves higher speed through more efficient data encoding, resulting in higher throughput. Mainly, more data is packed into the same radio waves. The chips that encode and decode these signals keep getting more powerful and can handle the extra work. There are two key technologies speeding up Wi-Fi 6 connections, MU-MIMO and OFDMA. MU-MIMO, which stands for Multi-User Multi-Input Multi-Output, is a technology that allows a router to communicate with multiple devices at the same time rather than broadcasting to one device and then the next and the next. Right now, MU-MIMO allows routers to communicate with four devices at a time. Wi-Fi 6 will allow devices to communicate with up to 8. The other new technology, OFDMA, which stands for Orthogonal Frequency Division Multiple Access, allows one transmission to deliver data to multiple devices at once. Wi-Fi 6 isn't just a simple speed boost. It is also about improving the network when a bunch of devices are connected. This is ever more important as IoT, 5G and smart devices together is predicted to increase the number of connected devices to 50 per household. Those added devices take a toll on your network. Your router can only communicate with so many devices at once, so the more gadgets demanding Wi-Fi, the more the network overall is going to slow down. The OFDMA feature that we mentioned earlier is the reason for improved congestion control in Wi-Fi 6. The third important feature of Wi-Fi 6 is that it is getting better security to tackle the ever-growing cybersecurity concerns. Wi-Fi 6 comes with a new security protocol called WPA3. For a Wi-Fi 6 device to receive certification from the Wi-Fi Alliance, WPA3 is required. So most Wi-Fi 6 devices are likely to include stronger security on launch. Finally, the fourth important feature of Wi-Fi 6 is that it can improve battery life. Wi-Fi 6 allows devices to plan out communications with a router, thus reducing the amount of time they need to keep their antennas powered on to transmit and search for signals. That means less drain on batteries and improved battery life in turn. This is all possible because of a feature called Target Wake Time, which lets routers schedule check-in times with devices. That is all folks, if you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.